I'm a misandrist. I'm a feminazi. I'm a communist. I have an Oedipus complex. I must be really, really, really fucking evil.
Transgender person, male to female.
You're gonna hate me.
I'm afraid of the day when I will get beaten up by Philadelphia police.
Right now.
This is the life of ADF.
In 2015 saw a dramatic shift in the internet and politics. Debates over feminism in the gaming and entertainment industry on websites like 4chan, 8chan and Kiwi Farms grew into the Gamergate movement. ADF was against all of this and viewed them as an enemy. She had just found a thread on 8chan that was being made about her, posting a screenshot of this to Facebook with a caption reading, CW. Racism, transmisogyny, misgendering, ableism, fun for the whole white patriarchal supremacist family. Yo, look everybody, racist, transmisogynistic, ableist cyberbullies harassing a trans Latina. Again, and the target? Me. She shaved her eyebrows during this time, calling them emasculating, and had the word Latin X tattooed under her lip. She also posted photos of herself holding money of different currencies, as she expects the dollar to collapse, saying, "The joke's on you, neurotypicals." As well as posting about transmisogyny, claiming that transmisandry isn't real. KFAB and KMAB trans people are not equal. KFAB trans people are an oppressor class when compared to KMAB trans people. Transmisandry is used as a shield to block the calling out of trans men and other AFAB trans people's misogyny. Misandry is not real, therefore neither is trans misandry. Men are not systemically hated for being men. If a woman actually hates men, it is a result of the systemic violence enacted upon us as women by men as a class. I repeat, trans women can neither be misandrists nor trans misandrists. MRAs and Nazis often market themselves as progressive in their propaganda. Last point, trans men have male privilege. Deal with it. Going after trans people who were born female. She also posted anti-Israeli bit strips, saying, "Imagine all the money that would go to all the needy trans women of colour instead of the state of Israel. I would like housing with that, electrolysis too. But Tel Aviv and Washington DC are the reasons we can't have nice things. Israel has nuclear weapons and never once was Dimona ever subject to IAEA weapons inspections. Iran has been subject to many weapons inspections for years and years. Oh, these white countries, how they tremble and lose shit when brown and yellow people get the atomic bomb. Ever since Mao's China, white European people foam at the mouth whenever a non-European country gets the A-bomb." Now, some needed fun facts about Israel and Iran from a Latin at trans woman who was compared to nuclear weapons by the Pope not even a month ago, in reference to recent comments by Pope Francis. On March 8th, ADF's friend Robin posted a Facebook post about how ADF was homeless and in desperate need of housing. She talked about how ADF would end her life in 2 days if housing is not found. She shared plenty of photos of where ADF walks around and sleeps at night, revealing it to be under a bridge. In the comments of this post, Robin posted ADF's suicide note that she had sent to her and told her to post. "I want to kill myself. I am giving my within 72 hour notice. March 8, 2015 at 6:21 PM. If you are reading this, it means I have committed suicide, or I am currently en route and final rites and rituals to where I will commit suicide. And obviously failed to delete this post within the time space of 72 hours from my Facebook. After all, space is important, but time is another matter. Time, something of the essence that is running out of me. Please don't be sad, it's for the better. The life I would have lived isn't worth living in because I am transgender, because I am disabled, because I am mixed Latina, because I will continue to be homeless, because no one wants to rent to trans Latinxes with disabilities here in Portland. What's worse, no one wants to rent to trans Latinxes with disabilities in Oakland, Berkeley or San Francisco either. I imagine Seattle, Olympia or anywhere fuck else will be no better. I was deemed too white for California, yet not white enough for Oregon. No one wants to be in my company these days. One type of my name on an internet search engine, Ahuviya Harel, and I'm completely avoided like something radioactive. I have very few friends in real life who bother to care / give two shits about me. It's not really fun not having anyone to ice skate with at Lloyd Center. Worse, I've been beaten up. Thanks, Occupy Portland. And made houseless. Thanks, Oakland, because of my internet past. And I fear such violence and ableism, or worse, will be visited upon me
once I try
and get a place. So what is the point of living anymore if I'm reduced to survival for the rest of my life? I can't work a job. No jobs are available to me due to my mental illnesses and trans feminine gender identity. Hell, my body isn't even marketable for the damn sex industry or sex work. Never mind I've been sexually assaulted 4 times in 18 years. Once in a goddamn woman's shelter in San Francisco 2014.
Nobody's going to help me because I have 2 Encyclopedia Dramatica articles.
And therefore a lolcow. And infamous on the internet. And because I stole someone's original character many fucking years ago. Nobody's going to help me because I used to be ADF fucking Cadillac Limousine Brougham Fleetwood. Whatever the fuck the damn name was on DeviantArt. Nobody's going to help me because I've been relentlessly cyberbullied for the last 7 years. Nobody's going to help me because I'm seemingly beyond help. Since being out transgender 5 years ago. Nobody's going to help me because I dropped everything from my miserable existence in Philadelphia and hoped an Amtrak train west to Oregon. Nobody's going to help me because my PTSD, anxiety, dissociative identity disorder and depression and sexual assault traumas prevent me, not just the casual trans misogyny cisgender women love to dish out on AMAB trans bodies, from accessing a homeless shelter, provided I were to survive out the 4 to 6 months waiting list first here in Portland. Nobody's going to help me because I am trans and white-passing Latina. I still wonder upon what the calculus is, how much more likely I will be incarcerated than white, non-Latinx, cis people, especially here in Oregon.
And
do not get me started on the odds of that happening in California or Pennsylvania. Math used to be my favourite school subject. Now it just hurts my head anymore. Nobody's going to help me, because I'm not on top of all the new social justice terms or have the best politics / political views. I got kicked out of my West Oakland home because I uttered a cold era term, third world, by people who don't fucking read history. Nobody's going to help me because I'm not trans enough. Nobody's going to help me because I'm not Latinx enough. Woodbury, Westville, Philadelphia, Sewell, Portland, Oakland, San Francisco, Berkeley. My blood is on your collective hands. Every time you misgender me, every time you harass me using the wrong bathroom, forced to shit on a cairn of rocks under a highway bridge because of your sex sag bathrooms that give 2 real options, get beat up or get yelled at. Every time you touch me without consent, every time you ignore and silence me, radical activists, you are fucking guilty of this shit too. I have not forgotten about TWAC Cascadia 2013. Every time you complain / Mitch, unconjugated verb tense of male bitching about my misandry, trans men's, you are fucking guilty of this shit too. This is not exclusive of cis men's. Plus, both of you have male fucking privilege. Deal with it, dude. Every time you say my sexual assaults never happen, 1997, 2012, 2014 and 2015 all happened. They are in part the reason this note has been written up in the first place.
I had it.
I love my mother. I love all I am to leave behind. The world is disabled and ill-equipped for a person like me to live in. I ask if my body is to be found. Big if. I prefer cremation over a gravesite, and my ashes dumped and scattered along the Oregon coast into the Pacific Ocean. A gravesite marker would get repeatedly vandalised by the people who hate me. After Kiwi Farms users found this post, they were not sympathetic, and instead made fun of the fact she sleeps under a bridge, nicknaming her the Bridge Troll. She did not kill herself, and her and a friend spent the day looking for houses.
Having her location to be so available online made her paranoia worse. She claimed she had a racist stalker after trolls discussed tracking her down to take photos of her against her will. After she herself is accused of racism, she posts, "To Kiwi Farms, this is what happens when you make false allegations of me engaging in anti-black racism and creeping on women and saying every sexual assault and all the child abuse I suffered was a lie. To a Latin app transgender woman, you get somebody who cares, who actually fucking cares and does shit to stop a suicide attempt. And I almost did it."
John Langley. Yes, John Langley.
"Of Red and Black Calf prevented me from jumping into Interstate 5 traffic in North Portland. I was on the ledge on the bridge, ready to fall 15 feet into the southbound lanes of I-5. John sped into the scene and grabbed from going over into traffic. Lastly, I am not in hospital."
Because certain people called anarchists do not fucking call the cops on marginalised people, like racial and gender minorities.
"And even if the police were to be called on me, and I was subsequently hospitalised on an involuntary hold again, it actually would not bowl too well on Kiwi Farms. 8chan, those two ED articles on Encyclopaedia Dramatica, keep up that surveillance you love. You are, even in the eyes of the law and the police, and any future ones arising from your continued harassment. So the next time when I attempt suicide, the police will likely get called. I get hospitalised, and believe it or not, this will backfire on the bully and stalker, not the survivor.
No amount of hospitalisations will magically erase the fact there's been cyberbullying and cyberstalkings, and there now will be serious repercussions to be had.
With or without law enforcement's involvement, the blood of your racism, transmisogyny, ableism, white supremacist shit rests on your hands. 7 years, this has been going on long before I came out as transgender. This time, you choose to escalate in real-time aggressions because you wish to destroy trans women completely and those social justice warriors on Tumblr so badly. You backed an oppressed person to a corner. Now you reap serious anti-cis white uprising. You will come to regret. This is 100% the fault of the oppressor classes." Despite this, the trolling and stalking got worse, even having a video of her filmed and posted online. A troll that went by the name Brozef Stalin interviewed a worker at the local cafe ADF would attend. She claimed ADF came in once with a male friend, and she assumed that they were a gay couple, and said that ADF was badly sweating and had an odour like he hadn't bathed in a while. She also saw ADF beg in the streets, and when turned down, ADF started shouting and flailing at the passerby before skulking off. After being shown ADF's Facebook, she said that she felt sorry for the poor dude. She then asked the troll why he was so interested in ADF. He told her, "Some friends and I heard about him on the internet and we were interested in him." After the trolling schemes were revealed to her and she was asked to be involved, she said, "Leave him be. He doesn't seem like his old heir in the head and really needs some help before someone gets hurt." And saying that the trolling could lead ADF further towards a mental decline. The troll ignored and dismissed her comments. In an effort to know what's going on and distract the trolls, she set up her own Kiwi Farms under the alias Hispanic Hitlermobile and used a photo of Cruz Bustamante as her profile picture.
Users were quick to find out that this was actually ADF and she was quickly banned before Null restored her account the next week to see where she would go with this. She posted in a thread about her saying, "Any chance to you all that Ahuviya Harel Araujo is simply doing what Hitler did and got elected to do in Germany, advocating for, in this regard, La Raza, and advocating for her nation, in this case the nation, being of trans Latinas for trans Latinas. Can we try another angle of analysis? I feel that the gender, sexuality, autism, tugboatage thing is far too oversaturated in discussion, secretly defending herself by trying to appeal to the Nazis on the site." Later, she used her Kiwi Farms account to defend herself more on the threads and offered to give away her whereabouts under the impression users didn't know it was her. In honour of the Black Lives Matter movement, ADF posted bit strips of new black and brown characters such as Missy Andrea, and Sonia, who many users compared and mistook for ADF in blackface. ADF explained, "I'm currently making a new cast of Bitstrips avatars of colour. Why, you ask? Because black and brown lives matter, and black trans women's lives matter. And there, I said it. Yes, I won't be starring in my own Bitstrips cartoons for a while. Also, this will blow every false charge ever made that Ahuviya Harel Araujo is racist. She has stepped back and let darker-skinned POCs take the spotlight on Bitstrips. One of these characters she plans to get tattooed on her left hip." She also posted a lot of her Tumblr posts in Spanish from this point on because, "Thank the asshole North Americans for continuing to erase my transgender and Latin identities here and off of here." She also defends what she considers fellow victims of the Gamergate movement, like feminist influencers Anita Sarkeesian and Brianna Wu. On Gamergate, she stated, "I think it's now reasonable and prudent to destroy the video game industry if all it does is act as a breeding ground for future MRAs and fascists. And no, I am not walking this comment back about video games." When she called Powell Bookstore transphobic as shit when it comes to bathroom access, a Facebook user going by Damien Vuk Burns told her to kill herself. She responded with a post reading, "This kid Damien needs his internet disconnected and video games taken away. White cis parenting has failed us again. Stop breeding such racist shit, please." She also asked her followers if her hair was thinning from stress and donated money to a number of trans charities before getting a new / patriarchy tattoo. She wrote a lengthy post called, "Why old cis people must shut the fuck up and listen to transgender sexual assault survivors," explaining other reasons her sexual assault happened. "It happened because I wouldn't not go along with his plans to manipulate me into supporting him getting joint custody of me in 1995. It happened because I questioned his pro-US imperialist politics. It happened because I dared to have an artistic side and shunned his coercive athleticism. It happened because he took advantage of a child with an autism spectrum disorder. It happened because I got a dollhouse on my 11th birthday. It happened because I refused to testify for him with the Philadelphia courts to get custody of my half-sister in April 1997, who I am now out of contact with because they do not know I am living as a transgender woman today. It happened because he perceived me as being effeminate, faggots, and didn't want jack shit to do with the cult of masculinity. But the reality being, I simply didn't have stereotypical masculine interests and hobbies. This angered him to no end. It happened because he feared his child's intellectual abilities would interfere with his impressive masculine designs he had out for me. And they sure did indeed. Whether it was my willful intent or absence of intent, as well as discussing the abuse Angelo did to her mother." Going on to post more, "Angelo did 74997 and rape denial is cis washing my herstory," quotes. After another user mentioned an upcoming tranny war, ADF responded, "Warned you about this war, Kiwi fag spoiler alert, you will spread yourself too thin and lose. You will not succeed in converting me back to cis white, for I have estrogen, spironolactone, Latina dad, and the will to stay trans with full force of 790,000 active duty strong, 2.9 million reserves, Australatina Defence Forces. The only good Gamergators are dead ones." After this, she posted more bondage photos after visiting a fetish store called The Wicked Grounds. A couple days later, her and Jordan hired out a motel, wearing their bondage gear and blasting out rap music. That day, she claimed she had her first consensual orgasm in a long while. She also claimed that she'd started work as a sex worker and that her first client was a cis Latina lesbian. After circulating rumours, ADF posted a photo about how she tested negative for HIV, saying she was giving the ultimate fuck you to an MRA / Gamergate troll group who has been recently spreading lies about my HIV status. She was also aggravated by Kiwi Farms user Cat Party posting the phrase 74997 never happened and goading her into suicide. She responded with a Facebook post written in Spanish that translates to, "You dare to say it to me in person, you bastard. Down with cisgenders. Up with transgender survivors of sexual assault. I am Ahuviya. Cat Party responded, Phil, I'll say it to your face. Meet me at the Wicked Grounds. 7/4/1997 never happened. Cat Party wants a fight? Okay, punk. Cat Party claimed she was waiting in a black SUV.
ADF claimed she was on her way, but had something to do in Oakland first.
There, she got an anti-patriarchy tattoo, saying, MRAs and Gamergators gonna get jumped here.
3 hours later, ADF was still not at the Wicked Grounds. Cat Party posted,
He's gonna show up long after I'm gone and be like, duh, the MRA ran. I was waiting, and you pussied out, Phil.
ADF claimed that she was just having delays on public transport and did arrive at the Wicked Grounds shortly after. Cat Party wasn't there. He posted,
Phil, you wait there. I should be there in an hour or two. I drive a black suburban SUV. If you pussy out and don't come out, I'll come in. I'm wearing a Kiwi green shirt. Get off the computer, punk, and fight me. Veto. Then, after I win, I will take the freeway. Pants up, cis dudes. Pants up, cis dudes. Pants up, cis dudes. Cat Party posted, Phil, you have to wait for me. I should be there around 11:30. Also, I need photo evidence. You and Jordan are there. At 6:52, ADF posted, I think Cat Party is too busy, not driving, but probably messing around with underage kiddos and that Mountain Dew and Doritos than to have a real fight with me. Don't like what I gotta say, then get off the computer and come over and fight me. After another 3 hours there, ADF eventually left, realising Cat Party was probably never gonna show. She bought a lot of BDSM gear while she was there. On her way back, a man pushed past her on the escalator. She posted, Next cis dude who tries to rush past me in a not safe manner on the escalator, I will reverse on him and cause him to trip. I can't speed up carrying 35 pounds of bondage gear in my pack on an escalator. The next day, Cat Pie posted, I really wish that we had a smarter cow than ADF. All he had to do was check the first couple of images from Google to see if I snagged the outside pick of Wicked Grounds. Enjoy the prank and the extra calories you two fatties took in. Cat Party? Or should I just call you CP? Making me wait at Wicked Grounds resulted in four things. Dinner? Ended up buying two impact play toys. Every worker at WG knowing about the stalking bullshit you're all doing. I knew that was a Google pick. I have frequenting WG a lot in the last week or two. User Batman vs Tony Danza suggested another fight at Lena's Soul Food Cafe in Oakland, saying that no matter who wins, he will give her credit for showing. Buy her a beer and even speak to Kiwi Farms Administrator Null about deleting her thread. ADF responded saying, No, I am setting the place this time. 24 mission, Bart, 7 p.m. tonight. Many comments on her Facebook suggested that she should just ignore them and move on. However, ADF was determined and just asked for more backup. So, a bunch of ITGs, internet tough gringas, want to fight your lovely evil trans-Latina of an edge princess.
Ahuviya Harel Araho.
Because Gamergators actually do leave their basements and start shit with trans femmes. I will be there at 24 Mission, San Francisco at 7 p.m. Could use reliable backup, preference for Latina/X folks to back me up.
Because a lot of my non-Latinx/non-Indigenex friends are fucking fleas, flakes, when it comes to defending/supporting Latina trans feminine/non-binary people.
And we will totally jump them for their Mountain Dew, Doritos and fedoras. User, the ultimate pickle, claimed that they were at a nearby taco place. ADF went there and her and Jordan ordered tacos while they waited and looked out. After 2 hours, she failed to find any Kiwi Farm users to fight and got the train back again. Kiwi Farms continued to threaten her. She fired back and claimed she was armed. Kiwi Farms are threatening to use firearms on me. Go ahead. They will go to prison. I dare to flash their guns on Telegraph Avenue. Shortly after this, she posted a very serious allegation. Somebody attempted to drive-by shoot me on 50th and Telegraph. 4 or 5 shots fired while a white guy was screaming, die, ADF, at me. Oakland Police and the California Highway Patrol are here. An OPD took my testimony and information and is questioning other witnesses on the 4,000 and 5,000 blocks of Telegraph Avenue who've seen the vehicle. I am not injured or hit by any rounds, just scraped from hitting the sidewalk. And not a half second too late. I am scared. I understand that these Gamergators and MRAs have fucking issues, but I do not take it out the people on Oakland. This post was shared all around Facebook,
before spreading into popular 4chan, Reddit and Twitter posts, as well as YouTube videos made about it.
Grab our fucking guns and, you know, go fucking nuts, you know? Hey, let's just go kill some random trans people, you know? Pew, 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 pew.
DeviantArt users started making art and comics mocking the allegation. Articles were also written by right-wing influencers such as Jay Miller and Ethan Ralph, stoking the fire of the Gamergate movement. On her secret Kiwi Farms account, she posted, "I did the shooting." She discussed and responded to other comments, saying that they could be used as evidence in the court of law, claiming that she was an officer from California Highway Police and they should turn themselves in for attacking her. On Facebook, she predicts that in 2095, there will be no white people in California. And yes, California will be a desert. She also posts a sex toy she calls Consenticles. However, in this post, her credit card was visible in the background. Cat Party posted how he could decipher her credit card number from the photo. Site administrator Null discouraged people from committing credit card fraud with it.
ADF responded by listing what she considered worse crimes than credit card fraud that Kiwi Farms had done.
On June 3rd, she posted, "Heads up, people, I'm going to have to make a fake status here saying someone opened fire on me in the Temescal section of North Oakland. I want to scare Kiwi Farms." A user on Kiwi Farms saw this and said, "This is most excellent. After his false flagging was brought into public, no one will believe him at all when he gets ambushed outside Tattoo 13 on 4917 Telegraph Avenue and gets beat unconscious with a sock full of rocks. Way to fuck up your life, Phil. You gonna get got." Believing they were gonna do this, she planned to record the whole thing, if it happens, posting from inside Tattoo 13. "Where are the Gamergate Kiwi Boogie Bros? I was filming as I entered. Maybe these Mountain Dew drinking basement dwellers were busy harassing other trans women in tech/video game industry, falling for the same trick a third time." The constant faking of shooting attempts eventually led to a fallout between ADF and her ex-boyfriend Michael, who up until this point had been one of ADF's closest friends and supporters. Until this Facebook conversation occurred.
"Why do you still talk about it like it was a real thing that really happened? This is about a community that thrives on discussion. And stalking and shooting and bomb threats to Anita Sarkeesian and FX. Except there was no shooting. Mike, do you support me getting murdered by Gators and MRAs? BTW, you don't mind I make your phone number public?" She then posts the first 5 digits of his phone number.
"Then stop defending Kiwi Farms.
Michael, quit it, or I will the last 4 digits. Snitches will get stitches."
And no, I don't, Ahuviya Harel Araho.
"You should know better than that. I don't want anyone to die."
"Mike, last warning, do not defend these people."
"I don't appreciate your threats, Ahuviya. I'll stop, not out of fear of my number getting uncovered. I don't care, but because I respect the fact you're telling me to stop."
Gar, punctuation.
"Then don't fuck with this trans Latin app."
"I wasn't trying to fuck with you.
Sometimes trans guys are just as fucking bad as the cis ones. JFC." She then posted, "I have someone's sorry ass to kick when I return to Portland next week." After being called a possible 2015 Lolcow of the Year, ADF said, "Nope. Actually, the whole reason they are doing this stalking shit is they are seeking a replacement CWC. I will provide utter disappointment for them if they give me that title. Peak Gamergate is coming. P.S. Solidarity with Anita Sarkeesian." She also implies she was adopted in a post about her Latin X identity. One of the people who responded to this on Kiwi Farms was a new user called Weeping With Pity. Someone who claimed to have gone to college with ADF
and divulged a lot of information about her.
From the details given, ADF realised that this was in fact Dusty, despite him claiming otherwise. She then posted, "Hi there, if anyone here harbours any form of xenophobia / racism against Latinxes, engages in any sort of Latinx phobia, or just like to question the legitimacy of my Latinx identity, you are to get off my friend list. Get off my friend list. In doubt, see 1 and 2. If you don't fucking do 1, 2 and 3, I will boot you off myself. There is at least 3 Kiwi Farms assholes on the friend list. Gonna start with white people first." On June 22nd, Michael set up a Kiwi Farms account for himself, using the username Tweaker the Cat. He created an AMA thread about ADF, divulging more information about her. He claimed that he and ADF were still friends, and that he would use her pronouns for this, and abide by her wishes of leave ethnicity the hell out of it. On June 25th, she declared that by 2016, she would have bottom surgery, and also renamed her imaginary country from Australatina and Bielvakia to Australatina Aslan Federation. During this time, she met back up with her mother and stepfather in Philadelphia, having letters in Philadelphia secured for her upcoming surgery. She ended her trip home early, as her mother and stepfather had gotten her pronouns wrong often, and didn't help her with getting an orchiectomy, saying that she now considers herself motherless. She decided that from now on she would change her name to Isobel Arouja Nieves. However, since Facebook wouldn't allow her to change her name at first, she threatened suicide before threatening to burn down every synagogue in Australatina, until Mark Zuckerberg lets her change the name, saying she had already burned 2 down and had 218 to go until there was no Jewish person left in Australatina. She was initially housed around this time by 2 transgender women, until a Kiwi Farms user got in contact with one of the women, informing her of ADF's online notoriety, her suicidal intentions and threats she had made. The woman terminated her contract with ADF. On Facebook, trolls created a fake account under the name Isobel Arouja Nieves. ADF found this and shared screenshots of the arguments and trolling she endured. During August, ADF visited a Holocaust memorial with Jordan. For some reason that day, ADF attempted to defecate on the memorial, until she was stopped by Jordan before she could. Jordan claimed that during a night they spent together, ADF tried to force her to use a homemade ginger root butt plug on her and anally stimulate her. Jordan felt violated and considered this cheating on her partner, forever being put off ginger. On September 15, ADF posted another video directed towards Chris Chan after Chris made transphobic comments towards Francine.
Pretty lady man.
A troll who had been posing as a trans woman and pretending to distribute fake merchandise of Chris's brand, Sonichu.
This is Isobel Arouja Nieves. So I've heard Christian Russian Chandler is attacking another trans woman up in Seattle because they're accusing the Francine of making money off CWC's Sonichu merchandise. All I can say to the poor capitalists in Rookersville, sorry, and it wasn't me. And the whole, you know, ragging on Francine being on Social Security, not cool, Chrissy, not cool at all. Some people need to make money to survive, and if it means stealing from the capitalist class, that's what has to happen. We don't know Francine's situation. We don't know Francine's situation whatsoever. So I think CWC just needs to lay off Francine right now. This is Isobel just giving her 2 cents on the whole thing.
After ADF got the impression that Chris believed that this person was ADF, she posted another video.
Isobel here. So CWC is demanding $100,000 he will never get from Francine, who thinks it's me. Well, we know that. Okay. First of all, CWC doesn't even know the difference between Berkeley, California, and I have to flip it over. Seattle, Washington. Chris, the distance between Berkeley and Seattle, Washington is roughly 1,350 kilometers. You realize that's pretty far and two states away, because you have to, from Berkeley, you have to take 80, 505, the 5, and then it continues through Oregon for 308 miles. Continue again for another, another 160 miles from Vancouver, Washington, to Seattle. And yeah, Seattle's like almost Canada. Bay Area, which is really Mexico. Because I hold this border to be the true and honest border of Mexico and not what America stole. Yeah, if you do get that $100,000, good luck with fending off court with bank fraud and all that stuff too. So, Isobel saying, become more geographically literate next time. Chris.
Kiwi Farms administrator, Null, made a thread claiming that ADF had died from trying to give herself sexual reassignment surgery. Videos are made in tribute. As well as a Facebook page about her death. Despite her still being alive and this never actually happening. In November, Jordan ran into ADF once again. Jordan posted, a former friend who is violent, a cultural appropriator, a liar, a boundary pusher, and even gave me lice earlier this year, was on the bus, death glaring at me. She also claimed that ADF was a bad influence and ruined a trans ladies' picnic they were at last year. Another user backs up this argument. She'd also post road signs following the Gender of the Day Facebook trend. She made a new Twitter account called Latinx Isobel. She tagged one user named Queer Dyke Kylie in a post saying, as a Latinx sex worker myself, this is very true. Kylie responded, can you clarify what you are responding to? I'm a BDSM sex worker. I am made to feel beautiful in this field. You haven't yet clarified what you're responding to. I am still confused. Your repeated requests make me feel oppressed and triggers my PTSD. She also responded to a Twitter post about how black kids don't call siblings half-siblings. ADF responded, yeah, but you blacks have weird extended family relationships with cousins and all. She also claims she is now vegan. That month, she featured twice on a popular meme making fun of communism. The poster and many viewers did not realise this was the same person twice. On the 3rd of March, ADF had her testicles surgically removed in order to aid her transition. She would post updates on this afterwards, saying, number of balls I currently have? 0. Number of balls CWC has? 9. 2 testicles, 7 sonotube balls. Happy 35 days, no balls whatsoever. 56 days, still no testicles. Sorry, Jordan, I had that surgery before you. And day 78, no balls, just my girl cock. During this time, she issued an arrest warrant for Donald Trump, saying, only advice for Trump, never visit Australatina. The cops will grab you, cuff you, and haul your white ass to jail. She also revealed that she'd be gradually moving back to Portland, saying it would be a better environment to get her vaginoplasty.
now saying that she'd be in Oregon for a more demi-permanent basis, after before she was on back and forth between California and Oregon.
After hearing this, Jordan posted,
"Glad a certain bad influence has left the Bay Area. They should stay in Portland. And they shouldn't even think about moving to Corvo. Jordan, I do have to come back for the following. Court, name change, gender marker, change, early May. Pack up the storage unit, box everything up. Sonju appointments until August. I will be back April 29th for all that and more. At least Jordan is supportive of the idea I belong in Portland, Oregon." During this time, she also got head tattoos. And before a court date, she received a phone call from trolls that said they were the official Gamergate. ADF claimed that they were sexually harassing her. After Yuzon Kiwi Farms claimed that she never actually got an orchiectomy, she posted graphic close-up images of her penis and empty scrotum online, clearly showing the surgery scar for all the Yuzon Kiwi Farms to see.
She got her new ID, showing the difference between balls and no balls.
At this point, she claimed that she was having disturbing dreams, including one where her and Jordan were shooting each other, and others featuring Corrine and Dusty. She was prescribed prazosin in order to stop them. She also said that she would soon come out as a sex worker to her mother. "I decided at the next phone call with my mum, I'm going to commit to her about being a sex worker. I'm hoping to tell her sooner rather than later. Whatever happens, I'm still her daughter. I just do not make enough money to eat anything other than dumpstered and or picked out of trash can food. So Kiwi Farms, where is the cheese budget? Lost the transportation costs and DMV for the new ID. Very simple. Your CWC never has to hook on the streets to survive." Dusty made a new Kiwi Farms account called Phil's Favourite Footlong.
This time being honest about who he was and answered more questions.
After ADF saw this, she responded saying, "When is the big bad favourite footlong Dusty gonna come to 510 and stab Izzy Halarajo with a straw? The evil trans Latina is so shaking in her combat boots. JK lol, not really. Dusty is a trans misogynistic gay man from college back to haunt me. Ah hell. Gonna double my dose of prazosin to deal tonight. Come at this tranny, I dare you." Afterwards, she reached out to Dusty privately, simply asking what he thought of her new name change. Dusty responded saying that he was willing to give her advice for improving her life, but not interested in small talk or ever being friends. Part of Dusty's advice was for ADF to change her privacy settings on Facebook, which she soon did, but before this, she posted, "15 minutes ago, I had a serious panic attack on Telegraph Avenue. I have been depressed relatively all day. Being in contact with someone from my pre-transition past, I feel so numb." Her Facebook posts were now no longer public and set to friends only. This, however, didn't stop many from ending up on Kiwi Farms. To combat this, ADF said she would clean the friends list of those who post too much anime slash otaku shit, as it's a red flag for Kiwi Farms surveillance. On his own Kiwi Farms account, Dusty revealed that he and Aunt Joyce had been in conversation for the last couple of months, after she tried to get in touch with ADF's mother. He posted the conversations that they had had, which revealed more information about ADF's upbringing and family situation. Because Dusty had used the same IP address for both accounts, Kiwi Farms users found out that he was lying about his identity in his previous account, and a thread about it was made. Because of this, Dusty stopped posting on Kiwi Farms soon after.
We caution you, it is graphic.
After the shooting of Orlando gay nightclub Pulse, ADF responded saying, "I wonder if a Trump supporter did this shit. They did." She also posed more conspiracy theories about the shooting. On June 25th, the UK voted to quit the European Union. ADF posted her feelings about this, predicting that Scotland leaves the UK, Ireland pushes, gets unification, the remaining six counties in Ulster, so Brexit, immediate slash long term, UK end. On July 5th, she had claimed she had gotten someone kicked out of a woman's shelter she was staying at. She also claimed that she maced a homeless man who tried to put her hands on her friend, and claiming she started smoking tobacco.
With so much tragedy after tragedy going on, I need nicotine to keep functioning. Not to be confused with weed, I have smoking marijuana since I got arrested at Occupy Philadelphia.
ADF made a threatening post towards her ex-boyfriend Michael. Earlier today, spotted the ex-boyfriend turned KKK We Farms troll, Michael. Content note, ex trying to get hold of weapons. So, Mike is going to be start carrying a hammer around Portland to attack me with if I have an encounter with him on the streets. Pfft. He's really salty he got freezed peach by the Portland police. Also, hammers are a bit heavy to swing. My extendable baton will knock that hammer out of his hand. All I really need to do is strike the forearm and fingers and he will drop that hammer. Yeah, just yeah, a hammer. No, that would get him hurt. If he thinks he can, that's a bad idea. Stop watching Tom and Jerry, it does not work that way. Also, I have pepper gel, lots of it.
On Facebook, ADF wrote a post directed towards Kiwi Farms. Dear Kiwi Farms, your intelligence is really bad. Your childish threats on my battleship are laughable. There will be no payee. Just a 5-year extension on my disability coming in November. And Donald Trump will not win the election. And tomorrow, somebody gets her second vaginoplasty letter. Also, I have been bashing out of the same neighbourhood as your esteemed forum user Tweaker the Cat to take some cool reconnaissance photos at 5 in the morning. Aren't drones awesome or what? Going on to Michael's apartment and taking pictures, posting about it in a threatening way.
Hi, Mike. If you see this, you are spying on me on Facebook. Psst, where is your tank? Our goddess who takes the elevator, hallowed by thy second floor. Thy kingdom come with a drawn machete in her left hand. Thy will be done on earth as you take two lefts. Give us this day our daily bread past the kitchen, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against room. Michael claimed he told the cops about this, and they apparently laughed in his face, quoting free speech, and to call them if he ever actually does anything directly. After Michael responded, saying, I would just like to know what to expect when I go to the library to volunteer, ADF posted, keep being a transmisogynist on Kiwi Farms, and I will make sure you lose that volunteer post at the Multnomah County Library. Threatening to get him fired.
A page on the website
namedtheproblem.com is created about ADF, featuring her as someone with a history of violence against women. On her Facebook she posted, Portland people, including ex-Portland people, know of any good taco trucks in town? This evil tran wants to piss off Trump and support some also taco trucks, cause you know. Posting a lot more about tacos in reference to Donald Trump's comments about Mexicans.
They're bringing drugs, they're bringing crime, they're rapists.
About the presidential elections, he says, I don't really care who the president is, because I'm going to fucking riot on November 9th if there is still no permanent housing for Izzy Hell. Enjoy your last 6 weeks of peace, Oregon. Posting a poster about her supposed riots, and now referring to herself as Izzy Hell. She started filming and posting videos of more people that she claimed were harassing her. On September 11th, she posted a video updating her followers about her current mental health.
Today I need to be very truthful and honest to all of you as to the severity of my mental health in the last 3 to 4 months and currently as of now. I am severely mentally ill. I have complex PTSD and dissociative identity disorder. The symptoms of both CPTSD and DID have been growing more acute in recent months. My very sense of self is slipping away and disappearing into the void. I live under constant threat daily of cyberstalking, which is in its 9th year. Kiwi Farms is still stalking my Facebook, even though that they have recently closed and made private the subforum that they had of me. And potentially, they are still stalking me in public on the streets in Portland. I've had no real capacity to decompress, let alone any semblance of safety outside of amassing weapons to protect myself. I'm also dealing with this stalking problem while still houseless. And with few people helping me out at all, my suicidal and homicidal ideations have been at its worst since 2013. And even with stable, permanent housing around the corner, I continue to get worse. My substance use is rising, marijuana use, alcohol use, and tobacco use all on the rise. Even the very act of trying to quietly meditate has become an act of futility for me. It used to be only sometimes dissociation and suicidal thoughts would happen. I am slowly losing my mind. Maybe I died back in 2013 with the nearly full Zoloft overdose on April 5th that year. Or maybe it was at Track Cascadia in the middle of Central Oregon, where I was accused of murdering my ex-boyfriend by the entire action camp. I am not exactly sure what it was. Sometimes I remember it one way, sometimes another. I think my headmates are hard at work, blocking me from remembering what really happened. So if I'm going to have a past, I now have it as multiple choice. I'm also stressing out about other things. The housing situation with Portland right now, and working with Cascadia Behavioral Health, and the rapid rehousing program that's promising to start looking for housing with me next week. As early as Tuesday, and I've yet to hear anything of substance that will get me off the streets before winter. And I move in, I start paying rent, and then I have to worry about moving my stuff that's in storage in a 5x5 storage unit in Oakland, California. I don't know what to do anymore. Lately, the last few days, I've been thinking that suicide is better than having to deal with all this. I don't know if I'm going to live next month. I don't know what I'm going to do.
She went to hospital for suicidal ideation. However, she was released after the hospital did not think that having a suicidal alter qualified for grounds for voluntary hospitalisation, as ADF switched personality after being admitted. She then considered suicide by cop.
ADF had booked female feminisation surgery for a future date. She also revealed that she was considering getting a future genital piercing, calling it something to torch the unwanted penis while waiting for vaginoplasty to happen. After finally finding some housing to stay at, ADF started raising money on the crowdfunding site YouCaring to help her recover from homelessness, to which many donated. After this, she posted
a series of videos to her followers. Guess who now has housing? So, on October 7th, I'll be moving into my new apartment, day 213, no balls, my own apartment. I don't even know if I'm ready for this yet, but I guess I have to get ready now. I gotta be responsible and have my own place and have to take care of myself now. Yes, that's South Park in the background. I am a wonderful girl. I deserve things in life. I deserve stability. I deserve to have my own space. It's been a long time. I mean, I've been on the streets for about roughly 5 years. It would be 5 years, October 22nd. But it's going to be 2 weeks short of that.
Next day, she posted that she had mixed to negative feelings about getting the apartment, and that she was noticeably not celebrating. There are deep reasons why. I honestly think the apartment came too late for me, and that my houselessness simply dragged on too long. This was in part the fault of Cascadia Behavioural Health, trying to force me to choose between housing and orchiectomy last fall. I ultimately voted to get the orchiectomy out of fear that such a surgery would not be available to me, opportunity-wise, ever again. I lack the capacity to be able to celebrate this as a victory. I have had a hard time allowing myself to have those celebratory feelings, because there's been so little hope for me, and basically it boils down to me constantly in a mindset waiting for disaster. No houseless tran has had anything similar to what I have been through, or at least not many, I personally know. I have been housing unstable since February 12, 2011. I move on to the apartment on October 7, 2016. My houselessness has ran as long, if not longer, than World War II in Europe. I'm going to have a lot of material needs to be addressed in the next few months, if not next few years. You simply cannot rebuild from 5+ years of houselessness overnight, unless there is a lot of help coming my way to make my apartment a home and be united with all my personal possessions. The short and intermediate term looks like it will be very depressing, and hopelessness might actually be worse than before.
Hi. I'm back in Portland. There's a couple of things I kind of want you to do for me. Especially if you're a cis person with money. One, give to my fundraisers, because I'm coming off the streets after 5 years and I need a lot of help. Material things, I need furniture for my new apartment, I need dishes, I need cups, I need blankets, I need a bed. Particularly one that I can be handcuffed to pretty easily. Oh yeah. Also, not only just give to me, give to Trans Lifeline. And buy a shirt from Greta right now. Do it! You are buying a shirt from Greta, and you're donating, and you will be donating to me. Please. Help this trans woman be off the streets and stuff. You should buy a shirt from Greta and donate to my survival and help me.
Come on, it's your favorite movie. Remember?
Michael. Yes. It's also the name of my ex.
I've just received a call from Secretary Clinton.
In November 2016, Donald Trump won the presidency. This caused a lot of backlash, and the growing movement Antifa began to form, heavily against what they considered right-wing fascism. This is something that ADF would eventually consider herself a very big part of.